On WFAN, the flagship station of the I Miss in the Morning program, weekday mornings from 5:30 to 10.
When we will head to Rangers hockey. Rangers and Devils, no Mike Richter tonight. An injury in the All-Star game, so he's out for tonight. We'll do a little talking a little bit later to Doris Burke. And those of you who read the papers this morning, and you know I'm going to be excited about this. The first woman to do color commentary for the Knickerbockers game on television will be Doris Burke. And those Marco Johnson, Pete Chilcutt coming off a 10-day contract with Cleveland, Eric Riley, Clifford Rozier. Nobody is going to make a difference, but you are going to need a body, evidently. Chucky Brown claimed off waivers by the Hornets. You knew that was going to happen. Played for them. Good friend of Paul Silas, the coach down there. That would have been a good person to bring in for a little while, but that is not going to happen. We'll come back. We'll take some phone calls. 718-937-6666. We'll open up those phones. I'm Susan Waldman. Be here till 7. We'll be right back.
Hi, everybody. Christopher Russo. Drive home with Mike and the Mad Dog every afternoon here on the Fan. Sports Radio 66 WFAN here in New York.
Is it?
When you see it, goodbye.
Headache the morning after. Well, you'll feel even worse.
Sleep Patrol.
I Miss in the Morning 2020 Sports. So many jocks, so little time. Here's Warner Wolf. Easy, big fella. Keep him in your mouth.
Good morning, Warner.
Good morning. Thank you, I-man. This I Miss in the Morning Sports Report is brought to you by Hackensack University Medical Center. The boo of the week goes to Baseball Commissioner Bud Selig.
Boo.
Selig has now ruled that Pete Rose, allowed to appear for the All-Star Century team at the All-Star game, may not accept the Reds' invitation to appear in Cincinnati at the Reds' 25th anniversary celebration of their 1975 World Championship team.
Oh, that's not good.
Come on. Selig said, however, Rose, the MVP of that series, may buy a ticket to the game and show up at the stadium. Weak.
Oh,
lame.
Man,
weak. I mean, come on.
That's insulting.
Enough. 10 yeah. years. The guy served 10 years. He's part of the team. Well, Dolphins running back Cecil Collins has dived through his last window. Collins, who is in jail on two counts of burglary, has been released by the Dolphins. The Dolphins figured Collins wouldn't be making too many first downs from jail.
No.
NBA, the Bulls lost to the Kings last night, 119-80. They dropped to 10-36. 10-36.
Not good.
If you can't win 11 games by President's Day, you're unpatriotic.
Shut up.
No votes.
Hey, wait, I got a smile out of the eye, man. Spurs beat the Sonics last night.
Well, where's Patrick?
Spurs beat the Sonics last night, 79-77. Here's Spurs' Avery Johnson.
We gutted out a tough, low-scoring, semi-sloppy, no-rhythm, motionless type went out.
Avery Johnson, all right, his description of the game. And Charlotte playing good ball. Now 6 games over .500. What's the secret in handling Anthony Mason and Derek Coleman? Here's Hornets coach Paul Silas.
Those two guys are kind of tough to handle at times, but Derek's almost done a complete flip-flop. He's a model citizen. Mace is not giving me the scowl as he walks off the court now, and both those guys are keeping their mouth shut.
That's the way to do it. Paul Silas.
This year.
That's it. Keep your mouth shut. And Dennis Rodman takes the court tonight. Rodman was asked if there was any pressure on him.
Is there going to be a lot of pressure on you? Do you feel that way?
I've already had pressure. I was married
once. Mm-hmm. Well, hey.
What was he playing for?
In the SATs.
Dallas.
Mutant.
Here's what we need. Says National Hockey League Edmonton Oilers general manager Glenn Sather increased the number of playoff teams from 16 to 20.
Good.
That's it. More teams in the playoffs.
Good
Lord. Start now.
What's right? That's right. Put all 26 teams in the playoffs. Forget the regular season.
Well.
And the odds on Tiger Woods breaking Byron Nelson's record, 11 straight PGA wins, 500,000 to one.
Good
a half a million to one.
Wow.
Now, just for the record, you know that Woods has won six straight PGA tournaments.
Yeah.
He won five straight. Then after winning a non-PGA tournament, he came in 10th in a non-PGA tournament.
Right.
And then won the next two. So he's won six straight PGA events, seven of his last eight tournaments overall. When Nelson set the record in 1945, he won 11 straight tournaments, which just happened to be all PGA tournaments. So it's a little different.
Hmm.
Although, in all fairness to Woods, certainly the competition is... There's more, greater competition now.
Byron Woods was playing against nobody.
Yeah.
Five guys on the tour.
That's right. Also, the guys were in the Army. It was 1945.
Yeah, it was Dan Jenkins, so out there writing about it, and five other guys playing. hello? No, come on.
So Woods's feet, I mean, is really...
I don't know how many guys tee it up make the cut. How many guys make the cut on a golf tournament? You don't know, do you?
I don't know.
I don't either.
No.
But it's got to be like there are 43 race car drivers in a NASCAR race.
Yeah.
I don't know how many golfers there are, probably around 45. Or maybe more.
Or fewer.
Less. Fewer.
Yeah.
Anyway, any one of those guys can win. I mean, there's 50 guys out there
that
can win on any week. That wasn't the case on Byron Nelson.
No.
Uh-uh.
So it's almost
Ben
like...
Hogan.
Racism.
Yeah.
We had Gene Sarazen. But the point is, his six consecutive are really... comparable to Nelson's 11.
I get what you're saying.
That's what I'm saying.
Maybe even surpassing.
Could be, because of the talent.
Yeah.
I mean, not to take anything away from Nelson. I mean, to win 11, go out and play 11 tournaments and win all 11.
Under any circumstances.
Yeah, right. No matter who you're playing against.
Yeah, you know.
I hear your noise.
Play against Mike and Chris.
That's right.
You know, they're going to win one of them, wouldn't you think? Well, not them.
No, not them. No.
So. Anyway. How about Patrick McEnroe making fun of Mike and Chris yesterday?
Oh, on the call in the golf tournament.
Mike did not take that well. By the way.
He didn't?
Well.
Why not?
Well, no, he was kidding.
Oh, Christ. Okay.
It's
all in fun.
Yeah. Mike's a little...
A little prickly?
Can be a little prickly.
Can be?
Yeah.
I'm a in the morning.
Critics and audiences agree. The show you know and love is back on track.
You just happen to mess with somebody I care about.
Tonight... The WB presents an all-new Dawson's Creek.
I was only looking out for you.
Is that what this is about?
What?
Us. You and me.
Joshua Jackson, Katie Holmes, Michelle Williams, and James Vanderbeek in an all-new Dawson's Creek. Then, on an all-new Roswell, Liz Parker is trying to forget Max Evans.
I really don't think that we should be together anymore.
Jealousy will cause Max to reveal his lifelong secret in the middle of town.
I couldn't just let you find another guy. When I'm not with you, I go crazy.
Jason Bear and Sherry Appleby in Roswell, right after Dawson's Creek, all new tonight on the WB.
It all starts tonight at 8, only on the WB 11.
Eddie, as you were. I have called you people here to talk for a moment about a matter of the utmost gravity. No, not the fat ass of Al Gore's incomprehensibly repugnant wife. Boys, it's even worse. More repellent, if you can conceive of such a thing. It does, however, involve the individual who is our second in command, the aforementioned Gore, Albert Jr. Subject today, war crimes, people. The kind that are synonymous, in the opinion of this old soldier, with this godforsaken Clinton administration, which we are thankfully about to put behind us.
Yeah.
I am happy to be able to report to you that there is now less than 12 months' time remaining before these hayseeds are gone. Or at least we fervently hope they're gone. There is a chance, I hate to tell you, that they might survive.
Oh, no.
In the guise of this Gore abomination, should the bastard get elected.
Oh.
There was an incident a matter of days ago, however, that should demonstrate to every last man, woman, and child in this country why he should never be elected to anything.
Yeah.
Forget the man's lies, his distortions, his attempts to undermine the Republic by putting the office of the presidency up for sale to our adversaries, foreign and domestic.
Yeah.
Forget his willingness to do, say, or undertake anything that might wring one single vote out of some hoodwinked sap.
Yeah.
All that you ever need to know about Albert Gore, boys, can be derived from one incident at one campaign rally at one stop in the great state of New Hampshire a few days ago. An Al Gore supporter stepped up to Senator Bob Kerry, who had stopped by to show the flag for Gore's opponent, Bill Bradley, called Bob Kerry a cripple and threw mud on him. Bob Kerry, people, a war hero. A brilliant man who sacrificed a limb to the war that Bill Clinton ducked. And Al Gore took a couple of rolls of snapshots of. Who called United States Senator Bob Kerry a cripple? Yes, Private.
An Al Gore supporter, sir.
I can't hear you.
An Al Gore supporter, sir.
You got a Monica Lewinsky in your throat, soldier? Sound off like you got what Al Gore ain't got. Balls.
Sir, it was an Al Gore supporter who called Bob Kerry a cripple, sir.
And threw mud on him.
And threw mud on him, sir.
And what did Al Gore do about it?
Sir, Al Gore lied about it and denied that it happened, sir. Even though there were unimpeachable witnesses to the episode, sir.
Exactly, Private. Some lowlife Al Gore scum uttered the lowest kind of insult to Bob Kerry. And Gore ducked it, just like Clinton ducked the draft. Yeah. Al Gore, who was over there in Vietnam working on his photojournalism merit badge, while Bob Kerry was over there leaving his leg in a rice paddy and saving lives as he worked on his Congressional Medal of Honor.
Yeah.
Al Gore lied about it, denied that it happened, and now refuses to apologize for it. Al Gore makes me sick. Thank you for your attention. That is all.
We were wondering what happened to Dennis from Boston the other day.
Yeah.
Good morning, Dennis.
Hey.
Where have you been?
I've been around. I quit smoking.
Good.
And I started again.
Oh, you did? Oh,
yeah.
Too bad.
I got up one morning, I looked in the mirror, and I said to myself,
Dennis.
Dennis, you're no quitter. I went out and bought a pack of lunch.
If your radio light sucks in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
Tiger Woods pulling out a miracle yesterday at the Pebble Beach Pro-Am National. Gogol had a chance to force a playoff on the 18th, but missed that putt and another to fall into a tie for second place with Vijay Singh.
You know, I'm not the first golf professional that struggled coming home at Pebble Beach.
No, you certainly are not, Matt.
Imus in the Morning.
While searching the web, how do you single out the information you need when all you hear is noise? Northernlight.com. It's the only search engine that delivers the web, prioritized, categorized, and organized into little blue folders. To help you cut through the clutter and find that otherwise elusive bit of information. Northernlight.com. Just what you've been searching for.
I used to drink ordinary hot cocoa, like Carnation or Swiss Miss. But then I found something smooth and creamy.
Ovaltine. Hot.
Creamy because it's made with milk, not water.
Ovaltine. Hot.
It's chocolatey, and it's good for me, too.
Ovaltine. Hot.
Now when I want something hot and chocolatey, it's not ordinary hot cocoa.
Ovaltine. Hot.
It's Ovaltine. Hot.
Drink Ovaltine. Hot. Compare it to your hot cocoa and taste the difference.
Imus!
Get to Mohegan Sun this month and pick up some easy money in a Mohegan Sun Easy Money Cash Giveaway all month long. Easy to plan and easy to play and easy to win. There's $350,000 up for grabs, guaranteed with 250 winners every day. You can walk away with $10,000, $25,000, or $50,000 in cash instantly. Just swipe an Easy Money card for a chance to win. Pick up your own card right there at the casino. It's both simple and spectacular. And of course, it's the Mohegan Sun way, so check it out anytime. 7 days a week, 24 hours a day this month. And while you're there, breeze into the Auto Body Express store. Grab some great merchandise. They may have some White Buffalo cologne left there. Check that out for Valentine's Day. Mohegan Sun, the closest casino to Manhattan. Take exit 79A off Interstate 395 in Uncasville, Connecticut. Call them at 1-888-226-7711. Mohegan Sun. Y'all win big one. Well, are you trying to choose a surgeon for your laser vision correction? Here's some important reasons to select Dr. Joseph Della Russo of the New Jersey Eye Center. So, Della Russo helped start laser surgery. Boy introduced down-up LASIK to the Tri-State area. Now he's introduced the newest generation of LASIK vision correction, the blind spot laser, a safer and more precise method of laser vision correction. There has never been a demand for a physician in this area as there is and has been, continues to be, for Dr. Joseph Della Russo at the New Jersey Eye Center. You can call him at 1-800-35-NJ-EYE. For patient convenience, consultations, exams, surgery, all available in one day. Like a car wash. Some insurance plans are accepted, financing available. I mean, they're going to try to make it easy for you. Zap them eyeballs. So give this moron a call, 1-800-35-NJ-EYE.
Joan London for Claritin brand of Aracetin tablets.
For years, I tried to deal with seasonal allergies. I took a million different over-the-counter antihistamines, had a cupboard filled with them. They made me feel drowsy. Then my doctor prescribed Claritin. One tablet means 24 hours of non-drowsy relief from seasonal allergy symptoms. In fact, after I talked to my doctor, I was amazed at how easy it was to control my symptoms. Claritin works for me.
Your results may vary. Claritin is available by prescription only. Claritin has a low occurrence of side effects, including headache, drowsiness, fatigue, and dry mouth.
Claritin is safe for children as young as 6, so my daughter can take it too.
For more information, talk to your doctor or pharmacist about Claritin. Or call 1-800-CLARITIN. That's 1-800-CLARITIN. Visit www.claritin.com and see our ad in Health Magazine.
Patrol traveling southbound on the Palisades Parkway. You can't expect a slowdown near exit 7 due to a multi-car accident. In Essex County, westbound 280 is a parking lot over the Stickle Drawbridge where there's another multi-vehicle collision. In Union County, smoky is how eastbound 78 looks at exit 11 due to a fully engulfed car fire. Eastbound belt, stop and go through Bay A Street where there's a broken down car in the right lane. And the northbound BQE still has some delays from Queens Boulevard through Roosevelt Avenue where there's an overturned car just being cleared. 30 to 35 inbound at the Holland to Lincoln Tunnels and George Washington Bridge. The weather mostly sunny and milder today, the high in the mid-40s. At the moment, it's a bright 29 degrees. This report's brought to you by the Food Emporium with the very best features, the unique colonial blend of Bigelow Constant Common or Earl Grey teas. 20 counts box, only $2.49 with a bonus savings card just for you. I'm Laurie McNichol for the Toyota Fan Highway Patrol.
It's coming up on 21 after the hour here on the I'm Mr. Morning program. Delaware Voser in, as Charles said. And Bush is trying to make something out of this, but what happened, of course, they didn't plan on. Was McCain, who didn't spend a penny there and or set foot in the state, came in second.
Yeah.
Beat Forbes, who spent $40 million in Delaware, probably. Or $20 million.
Spent a bunch. Millions.
Millions.
You're saying?
And now apparently Forbes is going to get out.
Yeah.
And Keyes is just going to continue to just persist for...
Well, we don't know when he will begin his reassessment.
I mean... At this point, it's just stupid. Well, at this point, it's just... It's almost gratuitous. I mean, what's the point? There's no point.
Just stop. Just stop.
I mean, you can look at Alan Keyes, and he's not doing it because he thinks he's going to get elected.
Oh, well, certainly not.
Because Alan Keyes is a lot smarter than Steve Forbes.
Yeah.
Forbes was doing it because, unfortunately, he actually thought he was going to get elected.
Yep.
Keyes knows he's not going to get elected. So he's just jerking our chain,
sure,
trying to jack up those election fees, which, by the way, may be okay.
Not a bad idea.
Yeah. We had him on the program in New Hampshire. I liked him.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you know, he's not without a sense of humor.
Not at all. No, he has a good sense of humor,
yeah,
in fact.
So, well, it's not, well, he's obviously a bright guy.
Sure.
So. He kind of veers off the road after a while, but...
Jacking up those lecture fees there.
Yeah, but that's essentially what he's doing, and I think I don't have a problem with that at all.
Getting that fee schedule up there.
Yeah.
Right?
So, work that deal out.
Sure.
Anything else going on?
A couple of lawsuits have accused an Amazon.com subsidiary of using software to track internet users to relay customers' personal data, IMAN, back to Amazon. The lawsuits were mentioned in a document filed with the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission. Amazon.com also said the subsidiary, Alexa Internet, and its software are the subject of an informal investigation by the FTC. The two lawsuits mentioned in the SEC filing allege that Alexa's software secretly intercepts personal data and then sends that information to third parties, including Alexa's parent company, Amazon.com. Alexa says the lawsuits have no merit, and the company is cooperating with the FTC.
No.
Of course, then there was the big story yesterday involving the Internet and what appeared to be a concerted campaign to bring major Internet sites to a halt. Hackers on Tuesday attacked three of the country's most popular commercial sites, eBay, Buy.com, and Amazon.com, just a day after they brought Yahoo to its knees for a time, and they did the same sort of thing, flooding these sites with all sorts of data that essentially just shut them down because nobody else could get into them. Oh. And the FBI is now looking into that. And in other business-related news, Proxy Monitor, which advises big investors, says Walt Disney shareholders should withhold votes from two directors at Disney Company's annual meeting because the board is too closely aligned with Disney chairman Michael Eisner. Disney has been criticized before for the makeup of its board, which some investors claim is not sufficiently independent.
Well, let's not worry about it.
So there you go.
So
that's about it.
Just butt out. 24 after the hour. Good morning, Senator McCain. Cindy, how are you?
Good morning, sir. How are you?
Oh, good. Do you actually campaign today, or?
We'll go around to some polling places and try to rip down opponent signs. have a few scrums, you know. You can't sink too low. But right?
Oh, yeah, you can. You can be Al Gore.
Sounds funny in the morning, then you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
Of course, we on this program, and particularly me, approach everything as to how it affects me.
Of course.
What does it mean to us in this program?
In fact, when you got married, we were so pleased that you finally found someone that loves you as much as you do.
Francis, we will be friends with our allies when we don't need each other, so that when we do, we can stand firm for peace and freedom.
You take the UNCF model that...
Vice President Dan Quayle.
What a waste it is to lose one's mind or not to have a mind is being very wasteful.
Well, you walk into the room like a camel and then you frown. Put your eyes in your pocket and your nose on the ground. There ought to be a law against you coming around. You should be made to wear earphones. 'Cause something is happening and you don't know what it is.
It is to lose one's mind or not to have a mind is being very wasteful.
I'm just in the morning.
Jenny, I heard about a...
...to enjoy a share in Forbes Publishing of just over $3.98 per child, or an aggregate of $19.95, subject, of course, to... taxes.
Meantime, the front runner in the GOP race, Texas Governor George W. Bush, says he is re-energized by what he interpreted as a telling victory in the Delaware voting.
Oh, sure.
Even though Senator John McCain emerged with 25% of the vote and second place, never having campaigned there. Here's how Governor Bush...
Here's what?
Here's how Governor Bush put it, addressing reporters.
Well, y'all saw what happened. We are rejiggered and energized. Came out of that other state up there, submissitated and all. But now, hell, you think you've seen me fight before? I'm absolutely flatulent. Man, I'm ready to fight like a starving Mexican facing a Saturday night meat menu, because I am a Ronald Reagan Republican, buddy. And here's my message to that Arizona boy. John McCain, tear down this wall. something like that.
On the Democratic side of the ledger, more health problems for Senator Bill Bradley, who was hospitalized overnight in St. Louis, Missouri, for observation. Doctors at St. Louis Barnes Hospital say there's nothing really wrong with him. They just simply wanted to observe him to try to determine why he's such a f***ing wimp.
At the IIW business desk, Ron Insana here, major internet companies are on high alert in the wake of recent hacker attacks that briefly knocked down some of the web's most popular sites. In addition to business locations, hackers also targeted news and information site CNN.com in an attack that lasted nearly 2 hours and seriously affected the site's ability to post stories. CNN President Rick Kaplan, speaking with reporters, said the mischief would do no long-range harm. Here's how Kaplan explained it.
Quite routine, really. At the time of the event, there were no stories scheduled to run, sucking up to the Clinton administration or the Gore 2000 campaign. And since the few stories we were able to post had no basis in fact, and were pretty much cooked up to hook some shyster advertiser or undermine the Republic, or both, I am happy to say CNN maintained its standards and weathered the storm quite well.
And finally, disappointment in New York City's religious circles had news that the Vatican has declined to certify what some believed was a local miracle. It was widely thought in the city's Latino community that the 700-pound rap artist known as Big Pun, who tragically died days ago, had miraculously come back to life. After an investigation, the Vatican has ruled that an amateur video of what was thought to be Big Pun on a Manhattan street corner was, in reality, Tipper Gore.
No,
please.
No.
That's not
necessary.
No, it's not.
No, that's just, that's
talk
awful.
About gratuitous.
Yeah, that is gratuitous.
Yes. Jeez.
It was 22 till the hour here on the Iverson Morning Program. And Claire Shipman, we asked her to ask the Vice President, Al Gore, if in fact there is anything, if there's anything that he will not do or say to be elected president. If there's just anything.
Does anything fall outside?
Does anything fall outside of anything?
Do you have any dignity?
No. We're hoping to get that answer sometime this morning.
Closed.
It's 4 in the morning. I must have shut them all down by the shape that I'm in. I lay my head on the wheel and the horn begins honking. The whole neighborhood knows that I'm home drunk again. If drinking don't kill me, her memory will. I can't hold out much longer the way that I feel. With the blood from my body, I could start my own steel. But if drinking don't kill me, her memory will.
I'm up in the morning.
Nothing's worse.
Oh, for the Fan Highway Patrol.
You know, I want to get degenerate into some ugly here, but we got to resolve this thing with this alien Gonzalez. Come on.
Out of Havana on an inner tube, a drift to the Atlantic Ocean. There was a Cuban boy, a six-year-old boy, who started all of the commotion. He washed up on shore. No, I can't take no more. No more for more. He was Miami bound, but his mama does drown. Little problem with her flotation. Papa said he can't stay in the U.S. of A. Fidel don't approve of emigration. Send him on his way. The time that kid was going, send him on his way. I'm sick and tired of looking at his face. No more ring around the rosy. Send him back to Havana. Kick Elias Kulo back down to Cuba.
Thank you.
dollars over here in their bilingual keys. Like another pair of pigs, soon this kid'll be big enough to play center field with the Yankees. Send him on his way. It's time that he was going. Send him on his way. I'm sick and tired of looking at his face. I'm all ringer in the rosy. Send him back to Havana.
Well, that's, you know, kind of an ugly situation, but I mean, come on here. Got the grandma's over here drunk, and speaking of somebody drunk, I mean, she had to be drunk, didn't she? What's that all about? So, Francesa was not here yesterday on the Mike and the Mad Dog show, and I realize you can't hear him around the country, but it's not a bad sports talk show. So, Russo was on by himself, and, man,
pretty good.
He sits in Mike's chair, you know, when Mike's not here.
Well,
does Mike know that?
Probably not. He would not approve.
So. And the big controversy here in New York is over this kid from St. John's who's been suspended for 3 games because apparently he had a Jeep Grand Cherokee. Was it a Grand Cherokee?
It was a Jeep.
Yeah, just a Jeep Cherokee. Big difference.
Huge difference.
Yeah.
We'll effort that information for the I-Man.
And he traded it for a Chevy Suburban. For whatever reason.
Right.
And the NCAA, in some almost incomprehensibly bizarre ruling, suspended this kid, I guess, suggesting that he had done something wrong. And a used car weasel called Russo and said, well, it would depend on what the mileage, because they're of similar value, apparently, these two, but it would depend on what the mileage. If it was, you know, if the mileage was similar mileage, then it was probably a wash, you know. If not, why? You know, if it's over 50,000 miles, up to 70,000 miles, it's that's a used car.
Yeah.
For you. Over 70, that's a rent-a-wreck.
It's a junker.
Yeah. But, man, I mean, I
who
think...
Who cares?
I think that was Russo's point. Who cares? Shut up.
He didn't steal the Jeep or the Suburban.
We're a little bit overthinking this, aren't we?
No, but then the kid's whining about it, and the St. John's coach is a total moron. The Jarvis guy with the weird-looking dude with the...
Mm-hmm. No, you mean.
Looks like a... He literally looks like a wacko out of Star Wars. Doesn't he?
Just a parsing.
He's a freak.
I mean, yeah, and he thinks that he's got this bizarre beard, bald-headed stooge with this bizarre beard that, man, is not happening.
Yeah, deeply troubling, in fact.
Yeah, it's so absolutely hideously unattractive, but it's also remarkably identifiable, so I suppose that's the reason he's going with it, but it is something that he ought to rethink. And Russo's screeching about it. But I like Russo, I have to admit. Well, Larry and Rob don't like him because he comes in the office and he only says hello to me. So now he says hello to... He lives in Connecticut now, Russo does. So now he sort of says hello to Larry because Larry lives in Connecticut. So, but... He used to never say anything to Larry or Rob.
Yeah.
So...
Good morning, Daddy!
Yeah. Whereas Francesa, he comes in and he...
Acknowledges the
room. He greets everyone.
Yeah.
And he gets a sense that Mike actually likes everybody in the room. So, where Russo, you know, just...
You get blown off.
Yeah. So. But it's, man, it's sports radio. That's what it is.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it is, sports radio.
That's
you
know, it.
It's just Stake Shapiro. That's what it is.
And whether the cars are a wash.
Man, I mean, it's just... And the St. John's coach is claiming that but the NCAA action was like somebody had come into his home and raped him.
Please, come on.
Honest to goodness.
Which brings to my mind why the coach would draw that particular analogy.
You just say, I feel like I've been violated or something somehow. Why?
Well, whatever.
Why that particular picture?
Yeah, so... I don't even know how this...
Couldn't get raped in a men's prison with a fistful of pardons, that guy.
Yeah, I mean, it's just a... That might have been someplace I wouldn't have gone to.
As long as we're drawing.
I mean, as long as we're going to start drawing.
I mean, Leonardo DiCaprio, maybe, but Coach Jarvis, I don't think so.
No, it's just... That's a fugly dude. Isn't he?
Very
fugly. That's a funky, fugly dude.
Mm-hmm. Deeply.
Deeply fugly.
Deeply fugly.
Yeah.
That's like a Whoopi Goldberg ugly.
Yeah, he is Whoopi Goldberg ugly.
Whoopi with a beard.
I didn't say fugly dude. All right, it's 25 FTR here in the IMC Morning Program. All right, here now from his home in New Jersey, our friend, Reverend Al Sharpton.
Everybody complaining about Brian Gumbel not being accountable as a parent, abandoning his children, refusing to pay adequate child support. So then how come the United States government is trying to keep a six-year-old Cuban boy away from a man who wants to continue carrying on his responsibilities as a father? I am outraged at this whole Elian Gonzalez mess. Like we don't have more than enough coochie fritos running around this country as it is already, we got to keep one here against his daddy's will. I say that unless Kathy Lee needs another muchacho to sew buttons on her polo shirts for 16 cents a day, we should send this kid's ass back to Havana y muy pronto. I am not a racist. I believe that Cubans are among the most valuable members of modern civilization. All you got to do is smoke a Cohiba Robusto to know they more than pulling their weight in the world, not to mention their many contributions to the fields of art, literature, music. In fact, about the only thing the Cuban people ain't all that good at is sailing. I mean, there's a reason why Cuba don't sponsor a crew in the America's Cup. You don't have to be Admiral Nelson to know that a couple of mattresses tied together ain't exactly seaworthy. Not to make light of the tragedy of the refugees. I'm sure life under Castro's dictatorship isn't utopia. You got to be pretty dissatisfied with your existence in the country to want to float your ass across the Atlantic in a damn minute or two. But if your itinerary includes a few days of treading water, then perhaps you need to choose another agent to book your travel plans. Jesus, ain't there no easier way to get into this country than doing the doggy paddle on a screen door through shark-infested waters? I know Cubans are prevented from traveling to the U.S. Well, then why not just fly over to Guadalajara and cross the border hidden in a potato sack with the Mexicans? The fact remains that if Elian's mama had only been a better swimmer, none of this would be an issue. Which makes the Gonzalez matter nothing more than a custody battle. Unfortunately, the mother left her visitation rights in David Jones' locker. The boy's fat grandmamas want him back. His daddy want him back. So why is this kid still living with his aunt? Is the quality of life in Miami that much better than it is in Havana? Maybe Elian don't have Pokemon or Game Boy down in Cuba, but I bet you he can have a whole mess of fun chasing a live chicken around his Papa Cena's living room. Go home, Elian, and while you're at it, take Gloria Estefan, Ricky Martin, and Jennifer Lopez with you.
I'm listening to Mike and Chris, and Chris is making a point about the Mets that it's more important that they win the series and go into the postseason, and Mike comes back and says, no, that doesn't make any difference. But then winds up agreeing with him, and neither one of them acknowledge. I mean, you listen to him, you wonder, are they in the same room? Listen to this.
Like myself, I think it's a much more important for the Mets than it is for Atlanta here these next 10, 12 days.
Doug, I take a different opinion. I think the playoffs are a different kettle of fish.
Man, I think if the Mets lost 4 of 6 here, Mike, and then went 4-1 against the Braves, I think you'd be a little worried about the Mets in the postseason.
So I do think it's more important for the Mets. And the Mets have...
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
They're not paying any attention to each other.
It's a whole nother bag of chips, dog.
A kettle of fish. Now stop using a food analogy.
Yeah. Different box of Twinkies I'm talking about.
Nissan offers you great value every...
Shaquille led the Lakers with 37 points, but the big story was his success at the free throw line. Shaq shot 15 for 20 from the line. Here's the Minnesota star Kevin Garnett on Shaq's free throw prowess.
Shaq had a great night. You know, he's hitting his free throws. And we weren't prepared for that.
No one's prepared for that. I mean, that's why they keep losing in the playoffs. Another T-Wolf showed his amazement. This is Tom Hammonds at Shaq's performance.
Not much you can do. I mean, especially when he's hitting his foul shots. I mean, I ain't never seen him hit that many free throws in 11 years.
And we're talking combined there. Also in the NBA, the league worst Chicago Bulls, they lost again, this time to Utah, 113-86. Afterwards, coach Tim Floyd tried to look on the bright side.
I thought our guys were real committed to playing with each other.
What?
Well?
That's about the only... They're committed to playing with each other.
Pornography.
Not particularly well.
No, man.
And as you obviously know by now, I'm Juan Gonzalez of the Detroit Tigers. He just signed the largest contract in baseball history, $140 million for 8 years. But Juan says, hey, don't expect me to do it all.
The fans need more patience. I guarantee you in 2 or 3 years, this thing is one of the best things in baseball.
No.
Don't pass the buck.
God almighty.
No.
You the hombre.
Not $17.5 million a year. We're not going to wait 2 or 3 years.
No, that's not going to happen.
Wrong.
No, wrong. When now?
Does not equate.
You the peso man.
By the way, what's the next tennis event you're covering?
Well, speaking of that, I was just about to bring that up.
Okay.
I'm glad you mentioned that, because we've been talking about Davis Cup.
All right.
And the U.S. victory over Zimbabwe last weekend. Well, yesterday, Captain McEnroe appeared right here on WFAN with Chris Russo on the Mike and the Mad Dog radio program. Mike was out sick, as you know.
Yeah, sure.
Which was actually worked out well because he hates tennis.
Actually, he was on a vacation thing, wasn't it? Or was he sick again?
We don't know.
What difference does it make? Patrick continues.
Here's Captain McEnroe with the Mad Dog, talking about Chris Woodruff's win in the final match over Wayne Black of Zimbabwe.
The key point of the match, John, is he's down 2-0 third set, a set apiece. I mean, he loses another game or so, you probably lose in the first round.
Well, he told me he was getting tired, and I said, the hell with you getting tired. I guess he just threw up an hour or two ago, and I started getting mad at him, and he finally played the way he was capable of playing.
Ooh,
talk about playing it tough on the sideline.
Tough love. There you are.
Speaking of Agassi.
Do we know what John said to him? We don't want to know, right?
With some things better left.
Yeah, okay. We got him to play. What difference does it make?
Got him to play.
Yeah.
Did the job. Did a great job on the sideline.
Sure.
Speaking of Agassi, he was forced to withdraw from the Sybase Open in San Jose because of a back strain, which stiffened up on him on the long flight from Harare to California. Here's Andre.
I would have been subjecting myself to the real risk and the real concern.
Yeah, how about missing the next Davis Cup match? That's real risk.
He won't do that, will he? No.
Not with Johnny Mack there.
Here's the deal with him. That you were going to find out for us, which you never followed through on. But you remember that?
I did find out.
And?
He's not married.
Oh, they're not married.
No. In fact, I think I said that if he is, he and Steffi are the only ones that know.
Okay. So Patrick was on his way to Hawaii.
Yeah.
Last time, and he said he would find out. And
he's going to explore that.
If they'd gotten married, apparently they have not. So.
Right. But they're very close, and they seem to have a great relationship.
But that is the real deal, right?
I think so.
Okay. Is that Liza Minnelli, Peter, what's-his-face deal?
Alan? No. No, it's not.
No.
We were wondering.
Well, no, but I mean, why would you want to even introduce that thought? Well,
it's been introduced already.
By you.
No, weeks ago.
By him again.
Yeah, by you again. Yeah. Well,
we were speculating.
Why can't we simply...
We want to dispel... What's wrong with that, anyway?
By the way, what would be Agassi's reason to... He doesn't need to conduct some charade, does he?
That's what I'm wondering.
Of course he doesn't.
No.
All right.
He must like her. She likes him. I mean,
yeah, what's
that's
not to like?
Both great champions.
It's simple. It's simple.
No.
That's all.
And Patrick's going to get to the bottom of it if there is anything, right?
If there's anything, especially in my new book.
We heard
which
things.
I just started scribbling in the office.
Behind the, what were we going to call it?
ATP Raw.
Yeah. Patrick McEnroe here, the Irish Money Program. It's 10 minutes now until the hour.
Go into the chapel and we're going to get married. Go into the chapel.
Winter over 120.
Come out, man.
Thank you, Phil.
Hey, later, Herb. How you doing?
Right.
You know the flavor.
Yeah. Here's Joe from New Jersey now. What's on going? What's going on, Joe?
Good morning, Mr. Imus. Yeah. I just had an observation about that Governor Bush cut you've been playing.
Yeah.
It sounds more like Foster Bush. You know, all we needed for him to do was belch, and it could have been a cut from an old Dean Martin roast.
There's Joy from Long Island on line four. What's happening, Joy?
Hey, guy. Do you know the one similarity between the Iowa caucus and the New Hampshire primary?
No.
Alan Keyes is the only black man I've ever seen in both states.
Yeah. I'm going to be a leader for peace. By strengthening our alliances, we will be friends with our allies when we don't need each other, so that when we do, we can stand firm for peace and freedom.
Well, or whatever.
Oh, my God.
Whatever we're talking about here.
That just gets worse.
Yeah, that just...
with each...
Wait a minute.
That's absolutely... wait a minute. Honest to God.
I don't know.
Beyond my ability to understand that.
Tough night for the Knicks as well. Embarrassed at home by the Miami Heat, 122-111. Game was rough on some Knicks fans as well who attended the game at Madison Square Garden, as described on the Knicks radio network.
Pass deflected out of bounds by Rice. It's still Nick Ball, five on the shot clock. And that basketball hit a woman at about the fourth row on the deflection. She appears to be a little shaken up.
She was probably running her mouth like most women instead of watching the game.
Yeah, I like them bodacious, but never loquacious.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
Walt Frazier, mired in his 70s. Walt looks like he just walked out of a Shaft movie. Exactly,
yeah.
Right.
Fly.
Get that fur coat, get that Pimmobile going,
yeah,
again.
Yeah, get out on 11th Avenue and work your ass, bitch.
Imus in the Morning.
Kometsky down the left wing, fades, drops it off for York, who scores! Mike York! What a pop!
Infinity Broadcasting, all rights reserved. Diamonds in the Morning. Roxy rules. He's the greatest thing since sliced bread.
Shut up.
It's also a presentation of WFAN and Westwood One Entertainment.
The flagship station for the Mets, Jets, Giants, Knicks, Rangers, and St. John's is The Fan. Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York, an Infinity Broadcasting station. WFAN 2020 Sports.
Good morning at 10 o'clock. This is Rich Ackerman, the Ken Griffey saga.
With a stupid, lazy Infinity American sportscaster, Warner Wolf.
Good morning, Warner.
Good morning. Thank you, my man. The long-awaited Ken Griffey deal finally completed yesterday, with the Mariners sending Griffey to the Reds for starter Brett Tomko, who was only 5-7 and an earned run average of almost 5 runs a game. Center fielder Mike Cameron, who hit .266 with 21 homers and 2 minor leaguers. Doesn't seem like much for Griffey, who signs a 9-year deal, an average of over $13 million per year. But according to Griffey, who turned down $148 million over 8 years with the Mariners, he didn't do it for the money.
It doesn't matter how much money you make. It's where you feel happiest.
Now, Griffey is having half of the $116 million deferred over the next 9 years and will not have received all the money till the year 2024, when he's 54. Here's Reds general manager Jim Bowden announcing the deal.
February 10th, 2000. That day will go down in Reds history, and will go down in Major League history, when one of the biggest trades in the history of our sport took place.
Biggest trades? How about biggest steal?
Yeah.
I mean, this is robbery. 4 nobodies for maybe the best player in the game today.
Well,
biggest trade. What a steal. Come on.
Something doesn't smell right here.
Man. Yeah.
I'm glad he did it, though. I think that's good to see that. That,
yeah?
You know, let's go play for his dad, play in his hometown. Sure. Cincinnati's a great place.
Yeah.
Right. Well, I was very enthusiastic about this whole thing, but there's something we don't know is going on here.
Seattle just gave him away.
No.
I mean, of course, he said, I'm not playing there, period.
Yeah, so now what?
But still, you would think... I mean, I know that he was going to play out his option. If not, they're going to lose him, get him for nothing.
Right.
I mean, they got 4 nothings. I mean, this is the most lopsided trade. If you just took players 4-for-1,
yeah.
you say, what? Well, where's the other 5 players?
Yeah.
You left somebody out, right?
Yeah, this is weird, isn't it?
Crazy.
Something ain't right.
Well,
I mean,
Looney.
In golf, first round of Buick Open, Davis Love III has a 7-under par 65, 1-stroke lead over Phil Mickelson. Tiger Woods 6-back, 1-under 71.
Means nothing.
Means nothing.
Zippo.
Means nothing, exactly, and here's Tiger Woods.
That's fine. You know, it's even if you're 10 or 12 back, it's fine, because there's a lot of holes to be played.
10 or 12 back? Call me even 15 back. That's 20, it. But it doesn't matter
that's
to
what
him.
I'm saying. Come on.
That's it. There's no limit.
No.
Nothing. There's no handicap.
If he wins this.
Oh, my God.
If he wins this one, then I think it's just insane.
What? 6-back, but it's only the first round.
Yeah.
Heck.
So he's.
Although Davis Love III is not Gogol. You know, the guy.
No.
Who, you know. Davis Love III's been around.
No, he sure. can.
So,
big difference.
Yeah. So is Davis Love II.
And Phil Mickelson and all of them.
Yeah, right. Phil Mickelson's that.
Yeah. See you do it now.
But
yeah,
I still think they're afraid of Tiger, too.
Yeah, well, they're looking, sure.
Yeah.
Looking over the shoulder.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. Only 3 games in the NBA last night because of the All-Star game. Suns beat the Wolves 101-85. Kings made it 11 of 12, beat Denver 96-84. And in the marquee matchup of the night,
what?
The 14-34 Grizzlies beat the 11-38 Clippers.
Good God.
112-90. Career high 44 points for Michael Dickerson.
You know, this All-Star, when is the All-Star game?
Sunday.
Who cares?
It's
like the Pro Bowl.
Yeah,
isn't it?
It is.
Yeah.
Yeah, no deal. Let them play.
I mean, it's just
like the hockey All-Star.
Do you even want to see it?
I have no interest.
Zero interest. Yeah. It used to be okay maybe when. I remember when Jordan played or Bird or something.
Or Wilt against Russell.
Well, something like that. Yeah. But, man, this
yeah.
is.
Yeah, Magic against
Magic.
Bird.
Yeah. Allen Iverson shoot 50 times.
Yeah, that's right.
I mean,
that's.
Come on.
That's right. Throw it up. You know how the. The All-Star game is in Oakland.
We have 7 seconds left.
All right, home of the Warriors. You know how the Warriors are promoting the game?
No.
They're saying, buy your tickets now to the All-Star game, where you can see real NBA players.
One of Walter and Adams, my
program.
Knock, knock. Anybody home? The technological...
Let's get February and get the baseball. I'll tell you that.
Oh, baby. Adios.
You catch up on things.
Well, Conrad Hamilton, is he going to be the guy? And they need some backup help there. I think they need help on the defensive line, linebacker. Obviously, they need a running back. Maybe they address that in the draft. But I really do believe, now maybe I'm wrong, maybe they're going to fool me, but I really do believe the Giants are going to make some moves in the offseason. Enough moves to be a much better team? We'll see. That's it for me. Be back tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock. Have a good one. Stay tuned for the dog. Thanks to Joni.
Sports Radio.
Welcome now, Joseph Abood, the fashion designer. Who,
good morning, guys.
McCain, I mean, I love McCain.
Generally, would you describe yourself as a log cabin Republican?
I don't get into the tradition.
Would you say yes or no?
Let's
you're a log
yes.
cabin. Yes, you're a log cabin Republican.
That's what I say.
Thank you very much. That's what happened. The log cabin Republicans are a group of Republicans who are gay.
You know, I
it
always
is
know.
On tape.
If your radio anyway, sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
Joe Frazier's daughter, Jackie Frazier, now wants to fight one of Muhammad Ali's daughters, 21-year-old Layla Ali.
Uh-huh.
After yesterday's fight, in which she won, Jackie made this challenge.
I want to kick your butt, Layla Ali. All right? I'm challenging you, and I want the answer. Don't make me come and get you. Yeah.
Don't make me come and get you.
Don't make me come.
I will hunt your ass down, girlfriend.
I'm in the morning on the Fan. Sports Radio 66, WFAN.
The Fan, Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York, an Infinity broadcasting station. WFAN 2020 Sports.
Good morning, 10 o'clock. This is John Binko. Reports of light snow, freezing rain, and sleet tomorrow, a high of 40. Your current Central Park temperature is 25 degrees. Skies are partly sunny. That's what's happening. This is John Binko at 2020 Sports on WFAN, the flagship station for
New York Rangers hockey.
Good morning, everybody. How are you today? Nice to have you with us on this Saturday morning in New York. Good to have you aboard. 718-937-6666. Two-way sports talk telephone number as we talk to you about the world of sports. Middle of February Saturday, we'll get you through the show here at 1 o'clock. Dusty Baker will join us a little bit later on. We're going to talk about the NL Central and McGuire and Sosa and Griffey and the Reds and hoping to get Larry Durker on.
It's Imus in the morning from 5:30 to 10 on The Fan, Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York.
With Mardi Gras right around the
corner. This is John Minko, WFAN 20.
Mets pitchers and catchers report to Port St. Lucie Tuesday. Join Jody Mack and Bob Wischusen Monday night at 6 for our countdown to spring training here on The Fan, Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York.
Well, hello.
Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York.
All right, for the new millennium, did you resolve to get more team in the own division? So you do that. I could possibly see that. All right, we'll talk some baseball and recontinue. Stick with us on The Fan.
My business is growing.
All right, Ken Griffey, of course, the big topic all week here on The Fan and baseball with the trade to Cincinnati from Seattle and, you know, what the Mets might still do and everything else. A lot of National League talk. It's sort of a cold February day in New York, but it's not that far away from spring training. And my buddy Dusty Baker, the manager of the San Francisco Giants, will give us some thoughts on what the might transpire here in the National League this year. And Dusty joins us on The Fan. Dusty, thank you very much. Good to talk to you again. Christopher Russo, how are you today?
Hey, I'm doing just fine. You know something? It's a cold, rainy day out here, too.
Not a bad time to talk a little baseball, Dustin. I tell you, Seattle was in a tough spot. They should have made this trade.
WFAN 2020.
Imus in the morning. Start your day with news, sports, and the Imus take on the world. Weekdays from 5:30 to 10 here on The Fan, Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York.
Legal Disclaimers Incorporated. We're the guys who say that.
Great. With reports every 20 minutes, this is John Minko, WFAN 2020 Sports.
The flagship station for the Imus in the Morning Show is The Fan, Sports Radio 66, WFAN, New York.
The Golden Gate Bridge, 4,200 feet of solid steel. Completed in 1937, it pushed the limits of steel construction and is still considered a marvel of engineering. Only problem is, it won't help you hit even a single...
Randy?
Well, that's a little off the mark. Actually, what I did was go to the annual trade show called the New York Toy Fair. That's where manufacturers show off their wares intended to drain you, Mom and Dad, of every last asset you ever had in order to buy your whining, insufferable offspring whatever this year's must-have toy item is. And since some of this crap now contains the same amount of computing power that a Trident missile had not so long ago, it can get kind of expensive. That's why I was comforted to see an old standby at the Mattel Company display, the Indomitable Doll Barbie. No wires, no batteries, no smart-ass chip inside, enabling her to flip you the bird in four languages or whatever. So how's a new Barbie a source of contention, you ask? Look for a moment at some of these Barbies I've gathered on my desk here. There have been 75 incarnations of these things over the years. Here's Barbie the astronaut. Here's Dennis Barbie, Ballerina Barbie, and so on. And here's this year's Jewel Girl Barbie, whatever that means. So, what's the big deal? Well, to reveal that, bear with me, we're going to have to lift Barbie's skirts, like this, this, and this. There. You see it? Barbies 1, 2, and 3 are identical in their pipe stem anatomies. But Jewel Girl here looks like she should have been named Tipper. Would you get a load of the gut on this thing? That's Carney Wilson before surgery, don't you think? Mattel says it's just a consequence of a new mold they're using or something. Actually, it's a great marketing idea. You buy Barbie now, then you have to go back and buy her accompanying plastic surgeon so your daughter and her little friends can play liposuctionist. If your daughter's friends are little boys and they're playing with Barbie, well, you've got problems beyond what we're prepared to deal with here.
Yeah.
But I'm digressing.
Yeah.
Anyway, some professionals in the mental health field see fat Barbie as a plus, a move toward reality, so the little girls won't grow up eating the nutritional equivalent of matchsticks and foot powder, trying to look like the old Barbies that seem to have been designed at Auschwitz.
Yeah.
What disturbs me more, really, if we're trending toward reality, let me lift Barbie's skirts again, is how come that? You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Where is it? How the hell is that reality? No wonder every Ken doll you ever saw has an expression like it just swallowed rancid yogurt. How's the poor sap ever going to get any? Of course, truth is, he couldn't get any, even if Barbie were equipped to give him any. He ain't got none himself. Let me drop the drawers on this Ken here.
No, no.
Is that sick or what? I don't know about you, but for God's sakes, I'm saying that Mattel has a lot more important reality issues with these things than whether they used to be too skinny. How about they don't have or the concomitant female apparatus as well?
Well,
no, I'm a journalist, reality-based. And that's why I've always favored the kind of doll I have right over here. Now, this didn't come from the toy fair, and some assembly is required in that you have to inflate this little number.
Oh, no.
Come on. There she goes, taking shape. How about that?
Fine.
Now, that is what I call anatomically, if not politically, correct. No, this isn't Barbie. This is, just let me read the label here, Summer, the ever-ready rubber Hummer. In that case, I may have judged too soon. Given the lessons of the Clinton-Gore White House, this thing may be politically correct after all. I think I'll play a little Oval Office here.
Oh. Andy Rooney here on the Amherst Morning Program. That's a little tedious, but it's unfortunate, yeah.
It is 24 after the hour, and Chuck has a little news. Some we didn't get to.
Yeah.
And but we need to know what's going on.
Okay.
In your shorts, 2020's forward.
Every day we go back, and when we go to production, I said, let's do some Patrick McEnroe intros.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I say that here.
Mm-hmm.
And by the time, a couple hours, 3 hours from now, by the time we get there...
I might have to even call my buddy Pat O'Brien to do one for me.
Yeah, I mean, it's not... It
was his birthday yesterday, by the way.
Well, it was.
Yeah, it was Pat's birthday yesterday, Valentine's Day.
How old is O'Brien? He's got to be in his 50s, right?
50s, maybe, yeah. Good shape, though. It looks good.
He does look good. Yeah. 52.
He looks like Nancy O'Dell's dad.
Except when he comes in here, he always looks like... It's T.J. Tucker's in his 1981 again.
Yeah.
Living high, baby.
Yeah, but apparently that's not the case. Anyway, well, good morning, Patrick. How are
good morning,
you?
I'm excellent. Slow night in sports last night? Hardly. Our own Charles and Connie McCord's Boston Terrier that's Stardust it. Wizard of Oz of O.J., heretofore known as Oz, yesterday won the Boston Terrier competition at the 124th Annual Westminster Kennel Club Dog Show right here at Madison Square Garden.
Oh, my God.
Connie said Oz was way up for the show today. Connie said Oz will stay on the circuit until Westminster 2001 and then retire to just be a dog.
That's right.
Well, I thought we were going to take the dog home this year.
This will probably, we were going to, and then this stuff started happening, and this will probably be his best year.
Go for a two-peat.
This is really, you know, they bought this dog for a pet, you know.
Yeah.
That was the original.
It sure was.
Get it? Because the other dog died.
Yep.
Now, the other dog was a...
Bud. Old Bud.
Had bug eyes like Boston Terriers do, kind of a Barbara Bush, Gary Bauer deal. And things started to go wrong with the dog.
Seriously wrong.
Yeah, health problems. Right.
In his elderly years, yeah.
Yeah. So one of the things they did, which is another indication that you make too much money, is, when, you know, there's another yuppie with too much money, is that they... Somehow a vet convinced them that the dog needed contacts, lenses.
How about laser surgery?
Well, you know, if it had only been available, yeah.
That was before laser surgery, right?
Exactly.
Laser for puppies.
So the dog's eyes already bug out.
Yeah.
And the dog was a very... I actually saw the dog's a very nervous dog. It was like a rodent on crack,
just
on diet pills or something.
Horrible exaggeration.
Well, it was, wasn't it?
Go ahead.
Didn't the dog shake and was just a nervous wreck?
No, he was just excited to see I-Man. Loved him.
So they paid $600, wasn't it, for the contacts, or even more, maybe?
I don't know.
$1,500 bucks.
Something.
So it was a lot of money.
Well, that included, it had cataracts, cataract surgery.
Shut up.
Well, it did.
Shut up.
Backtracking.
Cataract surgery, and then they...
So the dog's got the bug eyes. The dog's a nervous wreck. It shakes like a crack baby.
Yeah.
They put the contacts in. Well, the dog shakes his head. Yeah. The contacts weren't on 3 seconds.
It was just a trial.
See, no, but you never could find the contacts.
Well,
could
no,
you?
They're still out there somewhere.
And then what? Then the dog had a Letterman deal, right? Like quintuple bypass thing or something.
No, it had trachea problems. After which they tried to correct that, couldn't, so he had to be put to sleep. But that was
sounds like we may need a vet to get in here and explain all this stuff.
You know, Larry Kenny. Have you ever met Larry Kenny?
No.
Right. Oh my God! This is a horrible story.
He works on a breakfast. He does a lot of voices on a show. Brilliant guy. He's been on the show for 20 years, 25 years.
Tell him to do a voice for me.
He will.
My opening.
That's who would do it, him and Rob. Anyway, Larry lives up in New Canaan. So his wife is going up to some fat farm or some health deal or whatever, take mud baths or whatever.
But she just was, a spa.
Not a fat farm because she's not fat.
Just going to a spa.
She's going to a spa.
There, that's better.
So she said, and they have an old dog.
Oh, they give you rice all day?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. They have an old dog, and the dog is fine. The dog's fine, but she's... Larry's paying half attention. She says, "You need to have the dog taken care of. Go take him to the vet."
Mm-hmm.
So somehow Larry interpreted that to mean to have the dog put to sleep.
Why do you have to tell this story? Go ahead.
So he takes the dog to the vet, and they put the dog to sleep. So he comes back, and he's going to bury the dog out back of his house, but he doesn't want to do it during the day for some reason.
Oh my God!
He waits until it's dark, and some of the neighbors, by the way, saw him do this.
Well, hell yeah.
And they wondered what the hell was going
on. It's a Stephen King novel.
Because he's out back digging a hole. He buries the dog.
Hole in the backyard at night.
And a few days later, his wife gets home.
Oh, my God.
What's his wife's name?
Carol.
And the first thing she says when she gets home is, "Where's the dog?" Well, when she says, "Where's the dog?" he knows right then what the deal is.
He knows that he
was supposed to do, he wasn't supposed to kill the dog. Right?
Did not exactly do his job there.
No, that wasn't why we were going to the vet.
So he says, "Well, he's out in the yard."
He's out playing?
He meant in the yard.
Oh, so it was a bad deal.
Oh,
not good.
God.
So.
Scary.
He's out back.
It was ugly, wasn't it? And then Larry denies, though, that he... Larry tries to deny it, but that's exactly what he did. He killed a dog. Anyway, Patrick continues. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to interrupt you, but... Man.
No worries, okay. I-Man. We'll just keep on rolling here. You're speaking of money. $1 million? What's that, the I-Man's weekly salary? No. That's what it will cost Ray Lewis to get out of jail.
Good.
Georgia judge granted Lewis a $1 million bond yesterday, allowing the Baltimore Ravens linebacker to stay at his Maryland home while awaiting trial on double murder charges. Among those testifying on behalf of Lewis was Ravens owner Art Modell. Modell called him a good citizen. Also, Warren Sapp of the Tampa Bay Bucks defended his friend.
Great character. I mean, nothing that I would not entrust my own kids with. I would give my kids to him and allow him to watch after my kids.
Oh, well.
Oh, boy.
Ray Lewis is babysitting tonight.
Yeah.
Great.
Out with other women in limos.
Terrific.
11 months after surgery to reconstruct his throwing elbow, Kerry Wood of the Chicago Cubs threw 42 pitches in 5 minutes during the Cubs' first spring training practice. Wood, who was just 22, missed last season after having surgery on April 8th to repair a torn ligament. The Cubs have also enacted a new rule, no facial hair, no stashes, no goats, no stubble, nothing. Here's Wood on the new guidelines.
If rules are that I can't have facial hair, then I'll shave it off. I'll look like I'm 9 years old, but I'll shave it off.
Reports of Wrigley Field changing their name to Nair Field yet to be confirmed. The second half of the NBA season begins tonight. Knicks in Toronto and the Lakers play in Chicago, marking Phil Jackson's first return to the team, which he led to 6 championships. Here's Shaquille O'Neal on the second half prospects for the Lakers.
Everyone knows whoever has the best record will have the number one spot throughout the playoffs. That'll be very, very, very nice to get. But as long as we get some type of home court advantage, it'll be okay.
Say what?
3 and out in June, right?
Oh, yeah, first, second round. You need it all the way, baby. Hit those free throws.
Yeah, you know, the other night he hit, what was it?
15 out of 20.
Yeah, unbelievable.
Yeah, that was huge.
Amazing. Of course, the game was out of reach by the second quarter.
Well,
not quite that much pressure on.
Okay.
Continuing in basketball, but in college hoops, number 18 UConn over number 25 Seton Hall, 59-50. Point guard Khalid El-Amin of UConn finished with 11 points and 6 assists. Now, you remember the spunky guard has had his share of off-court problems, including possession of marijuana. Afterwards, he talked about the key to victory.
We did have fun, and that's one thing Coach emphasizes for us, to go out and have fun. That's all he's looking for. He wants us to have fun, and I think when we have fun, we're a much better team.
Have fun, baby. No munchies late at night. And as first reported right here on the Imus in the Morning program, 1 month ago, tennis legend Steffi Graf and Andre Agassi will wed in June, the anniversary of their first date.
You were supposed to have this exclusive story.
I'm telling you, this remember I told you?
Well, we read this.
Anybody knows, they know.
Oh, okay.
Wasn't that an exclusive?
Oh, I guess it was.
Well,
that's kind of weird.
It's not like one of my deals. It's very
just
weird.
A reach.
Yeah. All right.
That is sports, and I am Patrick McEnroe.
To Miss Ciliar now.
I'm a in the morning.
Every week.
Why? Why? Because he doesn't always come across as somebody you'd want to sit next to in your carpool.
To say the least.
Jerk, Warren. Warren's coming up.
It was on their face.
Warren Rutgers said that it was awfully serious.
You can say all that you want, but I want to tell you something. Did you ever hear Tom Precious? Did you ever hear Tom Precious?
In an improper, inappropriate manner for the personal gain of
your daughter. No, wait a minute. He never said for my personal gain.
Of your daughter. Right.
You, and that you putting
your
that in
your brother was indicted
for
misuse of the office.
Well, let me
are you denying that your brother was indicted
Bob,
for
gonna,
the misuse of your office?
Don't make me jump up here.
Using your stationery?
Hold it! Shut up!
I'm a sin in the morning.
Oh, that was me moderating the debate.
You're Warner Wolf.
Good morning, Warner.
Good morning. Thank you, my man. No less than 13 games in the NBA last night. The Knicks have scored only 8 points in the third quarter.
God.
Were blown out by the Raptors 91-70. Vince Carter may be the most exciting player in the game today at 29. A good indication the Knicks were out of it when Jeff Van Gundy had no starters starting the fourth quarter.
Bums.
The return of Phil Jackson to Chicago. And the I-Man's Lakers beat the Bulls 88-76. Shaq Fu, 29 points, 20 rebounds. And...
what?
And... 11 for 12 at the foul line. 11 for 12.
That's
for
huge.
The Shaq.
Break
good
him up.
Grief.
Wow.
Unbelievable.
Oh,
man. Break him up, Lou.
Yeah.
Hey.
Break up the Shaq.
Retire.
You know, that's not a... that's, they should have blown out the Bulls, shouldn't they? 88-72 is not a... 76 is not a big score.
Right, it was a close game.
Yeah.
They had a 29-8 run and pulled away.
Wow.
After the game, Phil Jackson on his return to Chicago.
Photographers, I couldn't see any of the people. Yeah, there are a lot of them out there, but it was a warm welcome, very friendly welcome. And the pregame ceremony, I thanked the Bulls for not doing anything extraordinary. I might have broken down and cried.
There's no crying in basketball.
Come on.
Get over yourself.
Huh? Please.
Oh,
of course there is.
There is?
Jeez.
Yeah.
Got to suck it up.
Yeah,
really. Come on, Phil.
Yeah. Seattle beat Michael Jordan's Wiz, 114-85, 41 for Gary Payton. Since Jordan took over the Wiz, they are 3-8 and haven't won a game on the road. Said Jordan, what have I got myself into? Kenny Anderson at 33. The Celtics beat the Jazz for the first time in 8 years, 101-99, after going 0-14. The Jazz have lost 10 in a row at home.
Good.
Here's Howard Davis and Cornbread Maxwell of the Celtics Radio Network.
Anderson drives around Ostertag to the goal, up and under, and lays it in. A spectacular move by Kenny Anderson.
Oh, doctor, spank me and wake me up. This man is unbelievable. Whoa.
Cornbread Maxwell.
God almighty.
I don't think he'll be winning any NAACP Image Awards.
Nah, man, unbelievable.
Cornbread.
God, spank me and shut up. Spank me and shut me up.
He sure does have a mean temperature.
God almighty.
All right, I'm in.
Yep.
You be the judge.
Well, I love this.
You love it. Tigers reliever C.J. Nitkowski.
Right.
Made $300,000 last year.
Mm-hmm.
He was 4-5. A 4.30 earned run average. He asked for $950,000.
Right.
The Tigers offered $600,000. And the answer is?
I'd say $600,000.
Wrong, I'm in.
You're
kidding.
No.
Wrong.
Oh, my
they
God.
They gave him $950,000.
Based on what?
Going 4-5.
4-5 with a... it's 4:30. Yeah. Oh, it's unbelievable.
Terrible, isn't it?
This gets you $650,000.
Oh, no, that's unbelievable.
A lot of pitchers rolling over in their grave.
God almighty. Go 4-5 with a 4.30 ERA and you get a $600,000 raise.
Exactly.
With a losing record.
Yeah.
No, I don't know.
Teach Wyatt to be a pitcher.
Good grief.
David Wells has called John Rocker an idiot. Says the Blue Jays lefty people will throw stuff at Rocker. If I was a bodyguard, I wouldn't want to be around him. He isn't the president, and nobody will take a bullet for him, no matter how much he pays him.
David Wells, not a real...
Well, yeah.
I'm going to run into him at a Mensa meeting either, by the way.
Not so fast.
Though I do kind of like the guy.
Yeah, he's colorful. In fact, I do like him.
Yeah. Well, they're Howard Stern butt boy, but that's irrelevant. Oh, well. Warner continues. Let's wrap this up, Warner. Come on.
All right. You ready?
You're on thin ice anyway with this book thing. This book thing is troubling.
A true portrait of the eye man.
Even Charles is troubled by this book, aren't you?
Troubling, absolutely.
Let's go to the videotape of Warner Books. I mean, it's just
funny.
Very concerned. But troubling. Yeah, there's some great stuff in here.
Thank you.
But the hummer on the eye man is just... I'm very, very concerned.
All right, here now on the... No, I'm into the morning program. Scott Minnie, Scott, so...
You know, every once in a while, when tragic events occur, like the sudden and untimely passing of Big Punisher, I stop for a moment to take stock. I think about all the little things we take for granted that, when combined, form what we have come to know as life's rich tapestry. And I always seem to have an epiphany as I inevitably come to the conclusion that it really is all about the Benjamins. Case in point, rapper, impresario, entrepreneur Sean Puffy Combs, the young gentleman who rocketed to stardom by capitalizing on the gangsta style, but who obviously isn't all that adept at living it. Although he was arrested in connection with a triple shooting at a Manhattan nightclub a couple of months ago, it's recently been revealed by prosecutors that he tried to bribe his driver to take the rap by offering him $50,000 and a diamond ring in front of a dozen police officers, which I'm pretty sure would not be considered an example of street smarts. Puffy, why didn't you just go back to the disco and rub your fingerprints all over the gunshot victims? Why not just get out the rhyming dictionary and find a couple of hundred homonyms for I did it? What the hell are you thinking? That's like Ray Lewis signing the receipt for the knife used in the stab fest in Atlanta. I mean, even O.J. didn't do something that stupid. And he did everything but hand Cato the bloody gloves in front of the crew member at the Mickey D's drive-thru. A gangster doesn't bust a cap in somebody's ass and then try to weasel out of it, let alone do it with 12 uniformed witnesses standing by. You should have been screaming your innocence. Ask the man why he all up in your face when there was obviously another gunman on a grassy knoll inside the club. Living the gangster life is more than trying to give money to criminals. Next thing you know, Puffy, you'll be donating to Hillary Clinton's Senate campaign. Wait a minute. You did donate to Hillary's campaign. Now watch this. Here's a segue for you. Speaking of the tragically dense and women with asses so big, you'd need a compass and a couple of Sherpa guides to circumnavigate them. Hillary pal Rosie O'Donnell finally got her wish and was summoned by one of the contestants on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire to be a phone-a-friend lifeline. Now, I know that anyone who's seen the program is already painfully aware it's not the new breeding ground for particle physicists, but if you're in a game show and get stumped and are turning to Rosie O'Donnell to pull you out, you're well on the road to Puff Daddy Land yourself. This f***ing load knows her IQ points by name. But even she's not so stupid she'd try to bribe someone to take a rap for her in front of witnesses. She'd just get rid of the evidence, take that 9mm and stick it way up under one of those big old flesh rolls of hers. What am I saying? She could drive her f***ing Lincoln Navigator up there so the cops would never find her in the first place.
The police coming straight from the underground. A young nigga got it bad because I'm brown. And not the other color, so police think they have the authority to kill a minority. Cause I ain't the one for a punk motherfucker with a badge and a gun to be beaten on. And thrown in jail, we can go toe to toe in the middle of a sale. F***ing with me cause I'm a teenager with a little bit of gold and a pager. Searching my car, looking for the product, thinking every nigga is selling narcotics.
I'm a in the morning.
It was not so.
Head of Patrick McEnroe, Gore 15 votes, McCain 101 votes, Bush 44 votes, and Bradley 3 votes. That's enough.
Stop voting. We're sick of this. Stop
right.
calling us. Stop calling
us. Polls are closed.
Polls are closed. That's exactly right. The votes are in.
Go get a beer.
So, McCord used to go to this, McEnroe probably doesn't even know this, McCord used to go to this Bible study class, and are you technically a born-again Christian?
Yes.
So you had some experience?
Yeah, but not a huge epiphany, a lightning bolt. I mean, it was just a slow process, but I would consider myself as such as having become an enlightened for me.
Well, what were you before that? You thought Jesus was just, what, a carpenter?
No, I just, underwent a
misguided
a
Jew once.
Cool,
no,
dude.
None of that. Why was it necessary to be born again?
I don't know exactly how to define that.
I made an adult commitment to the baby Jesus.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, well, I like that.
More reasoned judgment.
Yes,
as you matured with age.
That's even a better way to put it.
It's either that or doing 20 to life.
Yeah. 20. So, right. Now, this is from a guy who used to steal cars when he was in high school, by the way. Isn't that right?
Well, I don't know if it was actually
borrowing them for a short time.
Moved it. It was a misunderstanding, I mean.
And then he was going to these Bible study classes, but now that's all gone by the wayside, hasn't it?
Well, so we completed that. It was a 3-year course.
No. The Bible, studying the Bible is a lifelong deal.
Oh, absolutely.
It's not the rundown to the... To your all-white, by the way, Bible study class.
Oh, I couldn't agree with you more. But, I mean, the formal part of the thing was 3 years, and you were...
Now you're on completed. Your own?
Yeah.
You know, it's like the people I was in rehab with down in Hazleton in West Palm Beach. Of my class, I think I'm the only one who stayed sober.
Really?
I think so.
Well, congratulations. I have a lot of recidivism.
Well,
How about Jesse Ventura, saying it's a crutch religion? He said that again last night with Geraldo.
It is a crutch, everybody needs something.
Yeah, everybody needs a crutch.
Yeah, I don't think there's anything wrong with that.
No.
I'm not offended with that. If he means it in a disparaging sense or that it's a...
Then he's an idiot.
Or that it represents weakness, and that's not... That's lame, but then...
Well, he compared it to twisting his ankle, someone twisting their ankle and needing a crutch, to get around. So religion was sort of along the same line.
Oh, well, he's a moron. Jesus, that's unfortunate to somebody like Jesse Ventura, who's just smart enough that you can't put him on a program and make fun of him.
Because he can acquit himself all right.
Yeah, like Bush, you can make fun of him, he would know what was going on, but that kind of thing.
Imus in the Morning, 2020 Sports.
All right, please welcome now back to the program, Patrick McEnroe. Good morning, Mr. McEnroe.
Good morning, Mr. Imus. Good morning, Charles. This Imus in the Morning Sports Report is brought to you by the Hackensack University Medical Center. We'll start this sports report this morning with a quick quiz for Charles. Today is Michael Jordan's birthday. Charles, how old?
37.
Oh, that was a layup for him.
You realize we did this before, don't you?
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Oh, I must have been in
Do you have the monitor on out in the
room? No, we can't. We got to turn it up over there.
Oh, good. What is Laurie listening to?
Really paying attention out there, Mac and
Mel. Laurie's listening to CBS Traffic, right?
Yes.
That's where she steals her traffic reports from two other radio stations we own, by the way.
She's talking too loud on the phone across from me. Keep it down there, Laurie.
All right.
Speaking of Chicago, the house cleaning is complete. Big trade in the NBA yesterday. Less than 2 years since winning the last of their 6 NBA titles, Tony Kukoc, the last key member of the Chicago Bulls, traded to the Philadelphia 76ers in a 3-way deal involving Golden State. The Bulls get one of Golden State's first-round picks in 2000, provided it is not a top-3 pick. If it is, the Bulls will use the draft choice next the year after. The Bulls also get John Starks from Golden State, the former spark plug of the New York Knicks, and also forward Bruce Bowen from Philly. The Warriors get Larry Hughes and Billy Owens from the 76ers. Here's GM of the Bulls, Jerry Krause, on prospects for the future.
With 2 additional free agents next year and the youngsters that are here, we think that this is going to be a very good team in a fast way.
This guy looks like somebody hit him on the side of the head with a snow shovel, didn't he? Ever seen this guy?
Good team in about 10 to 15 years.
Fat little goober.
Job of the Hutt.
Yeah, oh, man, what a weasel.
How about the Sixers? Now, with Iverson leading the way and Coach Larry Brown, is Kukoc the missing link in a title run? Here's Sixers president Billy King.
I can't say that this one piece will get us a championship, because if I say that right now, somebody will be replaying it if it doesn't happen.
How about, that's like, right. The next morning?
Yeah.
Here we are. And here's another shocker from the NBA. After just his second game with his new team, the Dallas Mavericks, Dennis Rodman was suspended for a game by the NBA and fined $10,000 for not leaving the court in a timely manner in a loss to Milwaukee Tuesday after being ejected for the 23rd time in his career. Rodman on how he thinks he and the commissioner of the NBA, David Stern, can settle their differences.
I don't give a damn. You know what I mean? David Stern's need to clear our differences. And like I said last night, it's getting to a ring. He get naked, I get naked. Let's go ahead and get it on, brother.
That's a pay-per-view special.
Oh, my God.
Oh, boy. Dennis and Stern, buck naked. Boy, oh, boy, what a sight that is. Los Angeles Lakers, of course, the I-Man team with an impressive road win last night, 92-85 over Charlotte.
Kobe with 26, by the way.
That's true. We're getting to that. Shaq continued his metamorphosis at the free throw line, going 6-for-9. He's now 32 out of 41 in his last three games.
Oh, man. Wow.
As the I-Man mentioned, Kobe leading the way. Yes, 26 points, 6 assists, and 7 rebounds. Here's Kobe after the win.
I was just waiting, man. It was just a matter of time. I was trying to get my bounce, get my feel for it, and that's it.
Uh-huh. Just get it rocking, baby.
I like it.
Get it rolling. It.
You know the flip. Have we heard his record yet? Get his record, Lou. Have Rob get his record. His record's not out yet, is it?
Get us the Italian version. finally, in the NHL last night, of course, I'm a big fan of hockey. The Rangers continue to slide, losing 3-0 to Florida.
Good.
Now, hockey can really rile up some of our sports hosts here on WFAN in New York. In fact, the fans, Russ Salzberg, who comes on with Steve Summers right after the I-Man, he sometimes likes to go off on his hockey. But you know, I-Man, he's been taking acting lessons recently, Russ.
Well, I didn't know that.
So maybe he was using some of one of his newfound acting when he talked about the New Jersey Devils.
Okay. The Devils are an underdog, right?
Right.
Right. So if
do you think the Devils are a huge underdog?
What do you think? Maybe the Exorcist? What
isn't that a cunt that Brain gave? Did Brain leave that for Patrick?
Yeah, that had dust on it.
Yeah, I mean, that's older than I am.
Right out of closet, baby.
I feel tired right now.
Patrick McElroy.
Announcing a President's Week price challenge from one.
That's sad. More of an excuse, Patrick, but not you.
I'm going to switch to the Sacramento Kings. They'll be my team in the playoffs.
Oh, okay.
How about the Indiana Pacers, one of the favorites in the East? They defeated Toronto last night 109-101. Pacers win their 19th consecutive game at home. Jalen Rose with a career-high 32 points. Reggie Miller with a quiet 11, and maybe here's why.
It was good to get the first victory. You know, the first game always after the All-Star break because guys are tired. You've been off 4 or 5 days.
You're tired? After 4 or 5 days, it's called an all-star break. That's when you're supposed to rejuvenate, Reggie.
Yeah, come on.
Dennis Rodman has been slapped with a one-game suspension and a $10,000 fine for not leaving the court in a timely fashion following his ejection Tuesday, and Dallas has lost to Milwaukee in just his second game in a Mavericks uniform.
Should be slapped with a brick upside the head.
That will be fine.
Throughout his controversial career, Rodman has fantasized about masturbation during games in a pair of memoirs. Four women have filed sexual harassment suits against him. Yeah. He's headbutted a referee. He's kicked a courtside cameraman.
He punched his ex-wife and made her lose the baby.
He married Carmen Electra in Vegas during a drinking binge, and he got arrested twice last year for fighting with another patron in a California restaurant and in Miami with wife Carmen. But this would take the prize, his latest proposal to NBA Commissioner David Stern.
I don't give a damn. You know what I mean? David Stern's need to clear our differences. And like I said last night, it's getting to a ring. He get naked, I get naked. Let's go ahead and get it on, brother.
Scary.
What is that? Somebody who's got
what is the matter with this guy?
County's brain cells.
I mean, put him to sleep.
That's a little harsh. All right, here on the Amherst Morning Program, Bill from White Plains. Good morning, Bill.
Good morning, Amy. It's Bill from White Plains.
Yes, I know that. All right. How are you?
I really enjoyed that little byplay you had with Laurie McNichol. When's she getting her own show?
Oh, well.
Hey, I read that piece in Newsday the other day.
If she did get her own show, she'd be scary good, Bill.
Hey, I get it. Hey, that guy in Newsday said you're some kind of political guru.
Well,
that's quite a feather in your cap, my man. Doesn't this guy know you used to pee in phone booths?
I don't think he does, no.
Doesn't he know that you used to kiss men in the Marines?
I don't think he knows that either.
How about all that cocaine you snorted?
I don't think he knows that as well.
Fine PC road, huh?
Yeah, it was.
Hey, I really miss Breen.
Well, yeah, we don't know what happened to him. Well, he's doing the next games.
He loves his Knicks.
I know that.
She's still living with Ewing.
He worked with some woman on a game the other night, you know.
I think it went very well for him, don't you?
Well, when I heard of it, it sounded okay, yeah. It sounded fine.
But I like the two new guys you have, McEnroe and Wolf.
Oh, you do?
I remember that time McEnroe beat Borg in the U.S. Open Final.
No.
That was a great match.
No, Bill, get it straight here, Bill.
Oh, that was John McEnroe. This is Patrick.
Oh, that's right. I forgot. You have the Zeppo marks of the McEnroe family.
That's very nice.
Thank you, Bill.
This Patrick guy, though, he's a lovely guy.
Yes, he is.
Yes.
Emphasis on the word love.
Well, you want to take me out for dinner?
The score his opponent used to win by all the time.
That's just not funny.
I should stop making fun of him, though.
I think so.
He has enough demons already, if you know what I mean.
I might take out that thing that's in the I-Man's holster.
You know, Warner makes fun of Patrick.
Yes, I know.
There's a little jealousy going on there.
Quite a bit, actually.
Yeah.
From what I understand, Warner's out in the newsroom all the time. You know what his big line is?
No.
If you had Patrick McEnroe in a Grand Slam title, you lost.
That is not funny.
That's not good. That's cruel, Bill. That's horrible, in fact. That's below the belt, baby.
Hey, Warner's a good guy, though. He doesn't mean any harm.
No.
Wish him happy birthday for me.
Yeah.
I don't think
I understand he just turned the big 8-0. Oh, no. It's amazing how that guy that old can drink so much.
No, I don't think that's the case, Bill.
No.
I gotta go now, I mean.
Well, thank you very much for this call.
Thank goodness, Bill.
Bill from White Plains, let me take this opportunity to apologize to Patrick. I'm very sorry.
I can tell. I can see it in your eyes.
Well, I'm really upset about it.
I mean, it's just killing you, isn't it? I'm real sorry, Patrick. We'll let me rip it on you at your expense. Come on back next Tuesday.